Hi everyone, and welcome to this installation of Let's Learn. My name is Tabitha, and today what I'll be walking you through is automations. This is part of a two-part series, so today we'll focus on introductory, and then we'll dive into automations part two. We're going to review our example business, we'll talk a little bit about what automations are, how you can get started with them, the makeup of an automation, and then we'll demo all of the things that we discuss in our presentation. We'll end with some next steps and guide you to exactly where you can go. For today, we're going to be using our example business, Boone's Bandanas. Boone's Bandanas is an e-commerce business that sells different products through their Shopify store. They're also a nonprofit business that donates bandanas to animal shelters. They're using most of the main features within the platform, including automations. So we'll dive into exactly how they're using that today. Let's go ahead and get started. What is an automation? Automations give you the opportunity to alleviate some of your manual processes, giving you time back in your day by taking different steps that your contacts are doing or different steps in your business processes and automating them through ActiveCampaign. You can utilize automations in ways that are internal or external. You're able to build ways to communicate with contacts through the different actions that they're taking or things that will simplify your daily business processes. Let's talk about the things that we want to do. At first, we want to create our automation strategy. Then we're going to go ahead and dive in and we'll start building. It's very important that first off, you know that you should automate intentionally. Thinking about all of the different processes within your business will allow you to understand what you want to automate and the things that you want to continue to maybe do in your day-to-day. As you map out this plan, you'll have intentional plans and strategy for exactly what you're going to use automations for in ActiveCampaign. Automating intentionally will allow you to stay as organized as possible through the automations that you're creating because you have a defined process. Building modularly is thinking of it from bite-sized pieces. Instead of building very large, multi-step automations, what you want to do is break up those little automations and understand what you're trying to get your contact to achieve. Ask yourself, what is the goal I'm looking for the contact to achieve in this automation? What is the thing that you're looking for them to do? And once they achieve that, you can end the automation and have them start the next piece of your puzzle. It'll give you an opportunity to very easily dissect your automations based on the things that they're organized around. Now that you've really thought about your automation strategy as far as the little ones that you want to build, making up the bigger pieces, and all of the intentions behind it, you can start to really strategize what steps you're going to use and how you're going to build them out. Making the whiteboard real will allow you to really essentially map out everything that you're doing, whether it be through post-its on a wall, through an actual whiteboard, or through building automations from scratch in your platform. You can start to take these plans and make them a reality. Now, where do you get started now that you know all of this, now that you've taken the time to really map out your process, you're ready to dive into the software. So let's talk about a couple ways that you can stay organized, build your stats and reporting, and see exactly what you can do with your automations. Labeling is a way that you can start to take all of your mini automations, your modular automations that you've created, and organize them into file folders. Now that you're taking all of your processes and automating them, you want to keep them as organized digitally as you did when they were manual. Labeling is going to be an effective way to really take an opportunity to categorize and understand exactly what automations fall under what. Your stats are like QuickTime reporting. It gives you an opportunity to see exactly how many contacts are in your automations, what your open rates of the campaigns in your automations are, and if your contacts are achieving goals along the way. Now, recipes are pre-built automations that we've set up for you at ActiveCampaign. They're organized by industry, and they're tried, tested, and true to show you exactly what kind of pathways you can use based on the business that you have. You can edit them along the way to make more sense for your business, but they're here as a guiding force so that if you get stuck or you're looking for suggestions or ideas, recipes will always be there to help you along the way. Now, we want to talk about what makes up an automation. Triggers are going to be the action that the contact took in order to get into the automation. What is the thing that they've done to put them where they're at? Did they get a tag? Did they subscribe to a list? Visit a web page? Submit a form? Any of these actions, along with many others, will give you an opportunity to place contacts in automations and then follow that sequence of events based on what you're looking for them to do. Actions are going to be the steps that the contact is taking through that automation. What are the things that you're looking for them to achieve? Is this an internal automation where you're simply just trying to add contact data? Or is this an external automation where you want to send them a series of emails based on some steps that they've taken? Based on the goals and the automations that you've intentionally built out, you can determine triggers and actions as you start to build your automations from scratch. Let's go ahead, dive into the platform, and we can start building our own automations. Now that we're in the platform, you can see that we're in the automation builder. Before we get to building, we want to talk about some of the things that we discussed in our presentation. Here you can see a list of all of my automations. Each of my automations has a name and a label that follows underneath them. As we talked about, thinking modularly will give you a lot of bite-sized automations, which as a solopreneur or a person running the account on your own can become a little bit overwhelming. We don't want you to feel like that. You can see that you have 64 automations here, but if you start to filter by your labels, it becomes a lot more clear the intentions and the different things that you have running at this moment. If we were to click on our engagement automations, we can see that we have 5 automations, but only one of them is live. If you're trying to understand out of all 64 automations that you have, which ones are actually currently functioning, you can go ahead, filter by your active status, and see that only 16 of your automations are actually running at the moment. This makes your 64 feel a lot less overwhelming when you see that you have specifically 16 running. If you toggle over here to automation stats, you can see all of the different stats that fall in line with your automations. You can start to play around with open rates, understanding how many contacts have gone through the automation, and if you've set up any goals in that automation, you'll start to see different percentages of completion rate. As your automations get going, these numbers will start to populate more quick time reporting for you to see exactly what's going on at a glimpse. If you click on Create an Automation, you have 2 options. You can start your automation from scratch, or you can start to look through the recipes and find what works the best for you. As pointed out, if you open up your industry folder, you can start to find automations that are specific to your business type. You can then play around with different ideas and things that we've built out to make them fall in line with what you're doing in your business. There are some automation recipes that we recommend every account has, one of them being engagement tagging part 1 and part 2. We'll talk about that in our part 2 automation series, but you can see that it lives right here. This is a really good way to track the engagement of your contacts through automations. If at all we wanted to start building an automation from scratch, we could click Start from Scratch and press Continue. This is going to be a really good way to start to get familiar with all of the different start triggers and automation actions that you have. Here you'll see all of our different start triggers. Start to think about what actions are important to you as a business owner. You can see that there's some integration-based actions. There's some that relate to the CRM, to your e-commerce shop. You can see that there's some that are centered around campaigns, your website, actually subscribing or unsubscribing from a list, getting tags and submitting forms. These are all actions that you can tie together through multiple start triggers or use as singular entryways for your automations. Let's go ahead and we'll pick subscribes to a list as our example today. What we want to do is focus on our Boone's monthly newsletter list, and your automation runs once only lets the contact enter into the automation one time. We'll go ahead, we'll click Add Start, and it'll give you your blank slate. If we were to X out of our action folders, you can see that you're able to really see your plain whiteboard, and it's time to make it real. You can always name your automation if you'd like up here and just say welcome. Getting specific with your naming systems will help you understand exactly what the automation is about. Now that we're welcoming somebody to our Boons Monthly newsletter, we want to reopen our action folders and add our first action. Here's all of our different folders and options that we can use. You can see here we have sending options. Sending options allow you to build a campaign in your automation builder, send a site message, send a text message, or send a notification email, which is typically a really internal way of communicating with your other users based on things that are happening in the account. Think of your conditions and workflow folder as your internal actions, or the actions that build the pathways within your automations. They are what creates the steps that the contacts are taking through your automations. You have wait periods, which allow your contacts some time in between different actions. If-else statements, which will split the automation based on certain conditions. Splitting contacts based on certain actions. Go-to actions, which can bring them to any path. Goals, which we will talk about specifically in its own Let's Learn series. Automation-specific actions, using webhooks, and performing math. If you go to your contacts folder, you can see that this is the folder where you mainly will be adding and removing tags, subscribing and unsubscribing to lists, updating custom fields, updating any lead scoring, or adding and removing contacts to Facebook custom audiences if you have that integration set up. Your CRM folder will be a folder that you will use very, very frequently if you are a plus or above user that is operating the CRM. Your Salesforce folder also is an integration that you'll see if you have your Salesforce integration set up. Speaking of integrations, your CX app folder is all of the native integrations that we've created and built with in order to allow you to do certain actions within ActiveCampaign in external softwares. If you scroll through here, you may see a software that you use external from ActiveCampaign. What you can do is start to build pathways between the actions that your contacts are taking within the platform and things that you want to happen external from ActiveCampaign. What we want to do is create an email that welcomes them to our newsletter. We'll use our send an email step and we'll press create an email. We can say, welcome to Boons newsletter. Series. And this is not your actual title of your campaign. This is just the naming system that you're using within your automation. Once you press complete, it's going to take you to your campaign builder where you can build your campaign whenever you're ready. We'll go ahead and press save and exit. And then we can look at the additional steps that we can add within our campaign. We're going to save our step. Our email will be saved as a draft. And then what we can do is we can come to our conditions and workflow folder and add a wait period. Our wait period will allow your contact a certain amount of time before the next action. What we're going to do is wait for 3 days, and then we can use an if-else statement to ask a specific question. Our question is going to say, under the actions folder, did the contact open the campaign? The reason that we're waiting for 3 days is because we want to give the contact some time to open the campaign. You can see here that they'll bypass after 3 days and we'll ask the question, did they open the campaign? If yes, we can lead them down a second one action. If no, we can lead them down a different action. Maybe if they do not open the campaign, we want to send them a different version of that welcome. If they do open the welcome newsletter, maybe we want to take the opportunity to enter them into another automation now that they're ready for their next step. The opportunities for welcome series and different automations that you can create are endless. In Automations Part 2, we'll start to get a little bit more specific about the automations that you can create, whether they're from scratch or recipes. let's talk a little bit about next steps. We would highly encourage you to sign up for an office hour session. Office Hours is hosted by my team member, Shiv, where it's an open forum, no presentation, where you're allowed to come and ask any questions that you want about your ActiveCampaign account or questions that you may have pertaining to ActiveCampaign. We also recommend that you join the community. Joining the community will give you an opportunity to interact with users and customers just like yourself who might be doing things exactly like you. Subscribing to our YouTube channel is a great way to see all of our educational content. I highly recommend you do that, like the videos that we post there, and take an opportunity to teach yourself any of the other things you're looking to learn with an ActiveCampaign. Otherwise, I hope to see you on Automations Part 2, and thank you so much for joining us today. Have a great day and continue learning with ActiveCampaign.